Hello friends. More than 3 years ago, I released a video tutorial on my channel where I talked about my approach to the practical use of Zigbee thermostatic radiator valves, using the Mohs TV01 as an example. The setup included temperature calibration based on external sensor readings and different operating modes depending on external conditions. This video is an update as of early 2025, using the latest versions of Home Assistant and Zigbee 2 MQTT. I am using the same TRVs, but this logic can be applied to most other models that allow local temperature calibration. The package shown in the video is available in text format via the link in the description. You can easily adapt it to your needs. More details ahead, but before we begin, as per tradition, I ask you to like this video so that more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. A major update to Zigbee 2 MQTT to version 2 introduced many significant changes. This required not only adjusting settings but, in some cases, rewriting the logic. That is why, at the time of this tutorial's release, I still have not updated my two main Zigbee 2 MQTT instances, which manage most of my devices. Only the test server was updated immediately, as I use its Zigbee 2 MQTT instance to test new devices that I showcase in my videos. For my main system, to make the transition as smooth as possible, I set up a third Zigbee 2 MQTT instance. Fortunately, I have plenty of coordinators. This instance has been updated to the latest version available at the time of this video, 2.1.1. It was with this version that I worked to create the package for this tutorial. So far, I have migrated only 9 devices out of more than 150. As you can see, they belong to different categories, allowing me to study their behavior in the new version and, if necessary, make adjustments to the logic. One of the devices whose usage logic I had to update was the TRV. More precisely, TRVs, I have 5 of them, but using packages eliminates the need to create the same automations and scripts multiple times, allowing similar setups to be scaled simply by copying. To better understand the scale of the changes, here you can see 2 identical TRVs, both connected to Zigbee 2 MQTT, but the upper one is running version 2.1.1, while the lower one is on version 1.42.0. The number of attributes has been drastically reduced, and in my implementation, many things rely specifically on them. As the technical requirements for the new package, I took all the features that were implemented in the previous version, refined over several years of operation. This includes an individual heating mode for each room, which is turned on and off manually. Now, when it is enabled, the automations that adjust the TRV's parameters are active. And when it is disabled, all these automations stop working, and the TRV itself turns off and consumes almost no battery power. When the TRV is operating, its temperature should periodically sync with an external sensor. Since the TRV is located right next to a hot radiator, its built-in sensor does not reflect the actual room temperature. The TRV should respond to window openings for ventilation, in this case, also to the balcony door. In this scenario, a lower temperature is set to avoid wasting heat on warming the outdoors. The temperature regime also depends on the time of day. For example, in the kitchen, it is lowered at night since no one is there, while in the bedroom, where, conversely, no one is usually present during the day, a higher temperature is set at night than during the day. However, these adjustments are only meaningful if you have an individual heating meter installed. The package I am about to show you is a copy of my working package for controlling the kitchen TRV. The modifications are minimal and only relate to the specific architecture of my server. In this version, those elements have been removed so that the package can be used on any configuration. I store changes to the external temperature and humidity sensor readings in the database, as well as the parameters of the climate entity, which represents the TRV in the system. To avoid manually assigning a friendly name to each entity, it is more convenient to do this as a separate block within the package. To achieve the intended functionality, several auxiliary entities need to be created, which will be used in automations. This includes a ventilation sensor, which is necessary for detecting open windows or doors. In my kitchen, there is a balcony door and a window. Each has an open/close sensor installed. This template will react to either of them, as it uses an OR condition. To prevent parameter changes due to brief openings and closings, a 30-second delay is set here for both activation and deactivation. This block is responsible for the interface display, the type of binary sensor, and the icon appearance depending on its state. A sensor for determining the time of day, day or night, can be created using the time of day platform or, as in my case, as a template. In the video description, I have left a link to a separate tutorial on this topic, so I won't go into detail here. I will just note that my sensor is shared for the entire house, but if desired, you can create individual ones for each room. The next sensor is needed to determine whether temperature calibration is required for the TRV. It uses readings from an external temperature sensor. This value is displayed as its state. It also uses the built-in sensor readings from the TRV. In this case, the temperature value is displayed as an attribute, one of the few that remained after migrating to Zigbee 2 MQTT 2.0. I do not rule out that the attribute name may vary slightly on other models, so it will need to be adjusted accordingly. This is a binary sensor that will activate under the following conditions. From the external temperature sensor's value, converted to a floating point number, we subtract the value specified in the current temperature attribute of the climate entity, also converted to the same format. The resulting difference is rounded to one decimal place. The first condition is that this difference must be greater than one. That is, the external sensor's value is at least 1 degree higher than the TRV's reading. An OR operator defines the second condition, using the same formula, but it will trigger when the external sensor's value is at least 1 degree lower. In other words, the sensor will become active if the temperature difference between the external sensor and the TRV exceeds 1 degree in either direction. You can adjust this value according to your preferences. Temperature calibration itself is implemented as a separate script. This way, it can be triggered not only by automation but also manually. Let's go through it in detail. This TRV model, like many others, has a local temperature calibration function. This value can be adjusted within a range of -5 to 5 degrees Celsius and is added to the internal temperature sensor's reading. This value is displayed in Home Assistant as a separate entity via the MQTT integration. The entity is classified as a number, allowing its value to be changed both manually and through automation. This is what we will use. The script consists of 3 sequentially executed blocks. In the first block, the current calibration value is reset to 0. The TRV sensor then displays its actual temperature at that moment. Next, there is a 10-second delay. This is a buffer to ensure that the command executes and the data updates. The third block is the calibration itself. This structure allows the TRV's data to refresh, which occurs after resetting the local calibration value. Then, the actual difference between the external and internal temperature sensors is calculated and set as the new calibration value. Let's check it. In the Zigbee 2 MQTT interface, I manually adjusted the local calibration slider by 1.5 degrees Celsius. Here's how it looks in my interface. The external sensor reads 21.24 degrees Celsius, while the TRV, accounting for calibration, shows 23.5 degrees Celsius. Displayed here is the current calibration value of 1.5 degrees, and below it, the current calculated difference, which is now 2.3 degrees Celsius. Running the script resets the local calibration value. After this, the TRV sensor's data updates, and a new difference is calculated, 0.8 degrees in this case. This value is then applied as the new calibration setting, and the TRV sensor data updates again. The difference is now 0. Another block of the package is the operating mode. Logically, this is just a virtual switch. When it is active, all TRV control automations, which I will discuss next, are enabled, and when it is off, they are disabled. Due to my architecture, which includes 2 control servers, a primary and a backup, I implement such switches via MQTT. This is a binary sensor from this integration, which changes its state depending on the contents of the specified MQTT topic. This is how it appears in the Mosquito Broker. the sensor is currently in the launch state. When using two servers with interconnected brokers, this state is synchronized. The virtual switch itself is created using the template platform. Its state mirrors the state of the MQTT binary sensor we created. It can either be on or off. When turned on, the specified MQTT topic in the binary sensor receives and stores the value on. Similarly, when turned off, it stores off. Essentially, this is a simple virtual switch whose state is stored in the MQTT broker topic. This block changes the icon in the interface depending on the switch's state. The same functionality can be achieved using a standard input Boolean, which is also a virtual switch but operates locally. This is suitable for an architecture with a single control server. However, in this package, I will leave the extended MQTT-based version. Now we can move on to automations. Their order does not matter. I have kept the same sequence as in my original package. This automation calibrates the external temperature sensor readings with the TRV. It runs once every 15 minutes. But for it to trigger, two conditions must be met. The first is the operating mode, the binary sensor from the MQTT integration. If the heating mode is off, the automation will not run. The second condition is that the template sensor we discussed earlier must be on. It will be active if the temperature difference between the sensors exceeds 1 degree, or whatever value you have set. If both conditions are met, the calibration script is triggered. This means the calibration occurs no more than once every 15 minutes, but in my experience, it averages about 1 to 2 times per day. This automation sets the TRV operating mode. It has two triggers. The first checks every time Home Assistant starts. The second triggers when the binary sensor from the MQTT integration changes state. If you are using an input Boolean instead, specify it here. The conditions in this automation are placed in the action section using a condition selector. The first block activates when two conditions are met. The first is that the binary sensor for the operating mode is on, meaning heating should be active. The second condition checks the state of the climate entity, which represents the TRV. First, it checks if the status is not equal to heat, meaning any state other than heating. Then, using an or condition, it checks if the TRV mode is not equal to manual. Since all values are set by Home Assistant automations, the TRV must be in manual mode. If heating mode is enabled, but the TRV is not in heat, status, or manual mode, the action block is executed. First, the TRV is switched to heating mode. Then, it is set to manual mode. In this mode, the TRV simply maintains the set temperature and does not adjust it on its own. Next, the target temperature is set. I retrieve its value from another number entity that appears with the TRV in the MQTT integration. I use this for setting the comfort temperature. In my case, besides the local calibration slider, the TRV integration also provided 4 number entities, temperature settings for weekends, open windows, comfort, and eco modes. I decided to use them for storing my own settings. For storing the target temperature when the window is closed, I use the comfort temperature entity. You can do the same, as TRVs of this type also have multiple such settings that can be repurposed. This is very convenient. Rather than manually setting the thermostat temperature each time, you set it once using this slider, and the automation takes care of everything else. Returning to the automation, the second block triggers when the heating mode sensor is off. And if the TRV state is anything other than off, because when heating mode is disabled, the TRV should also be turned off. If these two conditions are met, the action block is executed, which turns off the TRV. Here's how it works. Heating is enabled. The target temperature matches the set value. Turning off heating also turns off the TRV. Changing the target temperature. Turning heating back on, the TRV is now in heating mode with the newly set target temperature. The next automation manages heating during ventilation. The trigger is a change in the state of the template binary sensor, which activates when any window or the balcony door is opened. The condition ensures that the automation runs only when heating mode is enabled. Next is a condition selector. The first block activates if the ventilation sensor detects an open window or door. In this case, the TRV's target temperature is set to a different value, which I store in another TRV setting called open window temperature. This slider is also available in the interface. In this example, the temperature is set to 16 degrees Celsius. The next block checks two conditions. The ventilation sensor is off, meaning windows and doors are closed. The second condition is that the night mode sensor is off. In my setup, it operates from 23 to 8 o'clock. For this block to activate, it must be outside of this time frame. If the window is closed during the day, the TRV's target temperature is set using the comfort temperature setting, as in the previous mode. This block activates if the window is closed while night mode is active. For this mode, I store the temperature setting in the Eco mode configuration. This way, I use existing entities without creating new ones. This is the third slider displayed in the interface. I still have one in used setting, Vacation mode temperature. It could be used for its intended purpose, but so far, I haven't needed it. If necessary, the target temperature can simply be changed. Let's test how this works. The windows are currently closed. I open a window, but the ventilation sensor activates only after 30 seconds, filtering out false triggers. Ventilation mode activates, setting the target temperature from the second setting, open window. Closing the window. Again, there is a 30-second delay. You can adjust this if needed. As soon as the ventilation sensor turns off, the target temperature is set from the comfort temperature setting. The final automation, as you may have guessed, controls night mode. It is similar to the previous one and could be combined with it, but I chose to keep them separate for clarity and to allow for future additional functions. The trigger is the night mode binary sensor. This is the only one I haven't covered in this tutorial, as I previously released a dedicated video on this topic. The link is in the description. The condition is that heating mode must be enabled. The structure follows the previous automation. The condition selector's first block activates when the night mode sensor turns on, at 2300 hours in my setup. In this case, the target temperature is set from the Eco mode setting. This condition activates if night mode turns off while the ventilation sensor is still active. The target temperature is set to the open window mode value. If both sensors are off, the comfort mode temperature is set. It is worth noting that this package can also be used with Zigbee 2 MQTT version 1.42, the last version before the update, as all these entities and attributes are available in that version as well. This allows you to make changes before updating and then seamlessly transition to the new version. This is what I plan to do in the near future. That's all for now. I hope this tutorial was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes. They help promote this video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I will include a link to a text file containing the package, as well as my Telegram channels, social media, and smart home discussion groups. Feel free to join. It will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to all.